Welcome to all listeners and viewers. Education is a complex process which includes the education of adults. Where comes the importance of teaching the neoliterates, adults, and which is considered as a continuing education? Adult basic education, it deals with many skills that is needed to survive in society. The program will promote among learners necessary knowledge, understanding, skills, attitudes, and competencies that will help them to build their capacity to participate in adult educational activities of different levels. Today's session, it is mainly concentrated to promote the program Master of Arts in Adult Education. Along with that, the postgraduate certificate program in adult education and postgraduate diploma in adult education. School of Education is concentrating on four areas. The first one, education. Next, distance education, then educational technology and adult education. Under the category of adult education, three programs the school is offering. The first program, that is postgraduate certificate in adult education. Second one, postgraduate diploma in adult education. And third one, Master of Arts in adult education. So in today's session, we are going to familiarize with these three programs. Let me see what is the nature and scope of adult education program. Adult education as a discipline is no longer restricted to literacy alone. In a wider connotation, adult education refers to any form of learning process that engages mature men and women beyond the limits of a traditional learning environment. It caters to a varied population of adult learners. It includes everything, learning for personal accomplishment, and goes to the extent of enabling a person to attain a higher education or professional degree. Normally, when we hear the term adult education, there is a tendency to believe it is restricted to the neoliterates. It's not like that. This program is designed for enriching knowledge and skill development as well as for enhanced career opportunities. And here we can see that this program primarily aims at extending educational options to those adults who have lost the opportunity and have crossed the age of formal education, but still they may have a desire to continue their learning. So for them, this program is very useful. It also provides the scope for learners to enhance the quality of life through lifelong learning. Let me see what is the feature of this program. This Master of Arts in Adult Education program, it is a two-year program structured both as modular and as an independent program, in the sense that after completion of first year, learners are awarded with Postgraduate Diploma in Adult Education, that is PGDAE. And along with that, we can see that this PGDAE is also on offer as an independent program of 1 year duration. Further, those who are holders of PGDAE are eligible to enroll directly into second year of Master of Arts in Adult Education. They will get due credit transfer for PGDAE courses since it is constituted as first year of Master of Arts in Adult Education. Normally, as learners, when you take enrollment, the first thing that comes in your mind is what is the benefit of taking this program. So let me see what is the prospects of pursuing adult education program. The first prospects, it provides opportunities for pre-service graduates interested in seeking career in adult education and allied areas. Secondly, self-employment opportunities for those interested in starting a voluntary organization of their own as a part of their practical activities. Thirdly, for those already in service, opportunities for career shifts into adult education area are quite possible. And fifthly, job opportunities cut across projects, programs implemented by government, universities, colleges and NGOs, among others. Next, let me see what is the eligibility for admission, what is the medium of instruction, duration, fee and frequency of occur of these three programs. Eligibility criteria for these three programs is any graduate can and take enrollment for this program. So graduation level is needed. Medium of instruction is English, but there is scope for writing in Hindi during examination, though the material is in English. Duration for PGDAE, the minimum duration is 1 year, the maximum duration is 3 years. For PGCAE, the minimum duration is 6 months, the maximum duration is 2 years. And for MAE, Master of Arts in Adult Education, the minimum duration is 2 years, maximum duration is 4 years. Fee structure for PGDA 6,400 rupees, PGCA 3,200 rupees and MAE 12,800 rupees, but it is subject to the ICNO norms. Frequency of offer, this PGDA is on offer once a year, that is in July cycle. PGCAE, it is offered twice a year, both January and July cycles. Then MAE is offered once a year, that is July cycle. So now it's time for taking admission, those who are interested. For PGDAE, MAE, that is offered only in July cycle, and PGCAE, which is offered in two cycles. Let me see the credits, number of courses and the nature of this program. First one, that is PGDAE, the total credits is 34 credits, total number of courses are 5, compulsory courses are 4, practical component is 1, no dissertation. PGCAE credits 50, total number of courses 3 and theory course 2, no elective course and practical course is 1. And for MAE, the total number of credits is 68, total number of courses 10, compulsory courses 8, elective or optional courses are 2, practical component 1 and dissertation 1. Any program becomes important when there is learning outcome. So let me see the program learning outcomes of Master of Arts in Adult Education. That is to develop in the students the national and international perspective of various aspects of theory and practice of adult education. Second one, to upgrade their knowledge and understanding of policies and programs of adult, continuing and extension education and development and welfare, among others. Thirdly, to enhance their understanding and skills of documentation, management and dissemination of knowledge and information on various aspects and processes of adult education. Next, to improve their knowledge, understanding, skills and abilities related to organizing and managing an adult learning setup. Next, to equip learners with the skills of involving the community in participatory planning, development and transaction of curriculum, as well as training, evaluation and research processes related to adult education and development. Next, to enhance their understanding and skills of networking at local, state, national and international levels for their personal, social and professional development. Next, to enable them to critically analyze, appreciate and promote the role of adult education in the emerging social, political, cultural, economic, developmental and other situations for effecting transformation at local, national and international levels. And according to the UGC's learning outcome curriculum framework, for every program there will be the attributes of a degree holder as well as qualification descriptors. Let me see what are the characteristics, attributes of a degree holder in adult education. First one, disciplinary knowledge and skills. That is, a learner will be capable of demonstrating comprehensive knowledge and understanding of adult education. Secondly, ability to apply self-reflection skills. Another attribute, that is communication skills, ability to express the issues faced by neoliterates in a clear and concise manner in writing, orally and other means of communication. Next, critical thinker, ability to critically evaluate the role of government and non-governmental organizations in adult skill development programs. Next, commitment to the larger cause, that is devotion to promote major interest of adults linked to larger for public cause. Next one, responsible and accountable learner. Irrespective of the nature and magnitude of consequences, an adult must own the responsibility for all his or her actions, good or bad. Problem-solving ability. That is, a learner should apply skills in participatory training and research programs for creating an educative environment for solving problems. Next, sense of inquiry. That is, capability for asking relevant questions relating to issues and problems in implementation of adult education programs. Next characteristic attribute is spirit of teamwork, that is the ability to work effectively and respectfully in a team to fulfill diverse needs of adults and their communities. Next, digitally literate, capable of using social networking in global adult learning. Next, ethical awareness, ability to formulate a position related with issues in adult education programs from multiple perspective. Next, self-directed learning. That is the ability to promote learner autonomy as a distance learner and to identify appropriate resources required for an adult education institution. Next one, leadership quality. That is empowering adult learners to learn and support themselves in their development. Next, lifelong learning, ability to acquire knowledge and skills, including learning how to learn, that are necessary for participating in learning activities throughout life. Let me see what are the qualification descriptors. First one, a learner should be able to demonstrate a coherent understanding of adult education as an area of study and its linkages with related disciplinary subjects. Procedural knowledge that creates different types of professional related to the subject area of adult education, including research and development. Use knowledge about how adults learn and understand the psychology of adults. Apply different learning methods, styles and techniques while working with adults. Next, demonstrate competence in dealing with learning needs, problems, motivation and prior experience of adult learners. Demonstrate competence in being aware of and taking responsibility for the institutional setting in which adult learning takes place at all levels. Next, equip learners with academic knowledge, research skills and practical employability skills. Let me see the program framework of postgraduate certificate in adult education. There are three courses. Three courses are compulsory, total credits 15 credits. Let me see the first course, MAE 001, Understanding Adult Education. It is a theory course which carries 6 credits. MAE 002, Policy Planning and Implementation of Adult Education in India, which is purely a theory course which carries 6 credits. Then MAEL 002, it is a practical work, community based practical activities, which carries 3 credits. Next, coming to the next program, that is PGDAE. This is the second program in adult education which is offered by School of Education. The program framework is like this. This PGDAE is the first year of MAE. There we can see there are 4 courses, 5 courses are compulsory, total credits 34, 4 theory courses, 1 practical courses, combining together 5 courses. First course, that is Understanding Adult Education, which is a theory course which carries 6 credits. Then MAE 002, Policy Planning and Implementation of Adult Education in India, that is a theory course which carries 6 credits. Then comes MAE 003, Knowledge Management, Information Dissemination and Networking in Adult Education, which is a theory course which carries 6 credits. Then comes MAE 016, Educational Research, which gives you understanding about the different activities of research. Then, which is a theory course, the credits will be 6. Then comes the practical work components. The first one, community based practical activities, which carries 3 credits. Second one, workshop based practical activities, which carries 2 credits. Next comes adult education training center or institution based practical activities, which carries 5 credits. So the total credits of PGDAE program is 34. Then comes Master of Arts in Adult Education. Already I have told, the PGDAE is the first year of Master of Arts in Adult Education. That is the first year course of Master of Arts in Adult Education. Coming to the second year of Master of Arts in Adult Education, there are 3 courses. 2 theory and 1 dissertation are compulsory and others are optional. And the total credits for the second year is 34. But the total credits for Master of Arts in Adult Education is 68. Let me see the courses. MAE 004, Extension Education and Development, theory course which is compulsory, 6 credit. MAE 005, Population and Development Education Theory, which is compulsory, 6 credit. Then MAEE 001, Sustainable Development, that is a theory course but it is optional or elective, which carries 6 credit. MAEC 061, Open and Distance Learning System, it is a theory course but it is comes under the category of optional or elective, which carries 6 credit. Then comes MAEE 002, Basics of Legal Awareness, that is a theory course that is also optional or elective, which carries 6 credits. Then MAEC 062, Vocational Education, which is a theory course and this is also optional or elective, which carries 6 credit. Then comes Dissertation Work, MAEP 001, which carries 10 credits, and there is total credits comes 34. But here you have to see that you can see some asterisk which can be seen on the screen. It indicates that only one course is to be opted out of MAEE 001 and MAEC 061 courses. They are elective or optional courses. Then you can see the double asterisk, that is indicates that only one course is to be opted out of MAEE 002 and MAEC 062. Let me come to the details of the block and the unit titles, what is coming in each course. When we look at this first course, that is Understanding Adult Education, which is MAE 001, there we can see that the blocks, the first block, it is dealing with the development of adult education. Under it, the major discussions are on the basic concept of adult education, the different terms related to it, the features and objectives, then the historical perspective of Indian adult education. Next comes the global, regional, national scenarios on literacy, then the policy on adult and lifelong learning. There the national and international perspectives are covered. In block 2, which is titled Foundations of Adult Education, you can see that there are adult and lifelong learning, an overview of philosophical foundations. Then comes the philosophical foundations of trends in philosophical foundations of adult education. Then psychology of adult learning and motivation. Then comes sociological background of adult and lifelong learning. Third block titled Curriculum Development, Transaction and Evaluation. There the units are Curriculum Development in Adult Education, Community Participation in Curriculum Development and Transaction, Teaching and Training Methods and Techniques in Adult Education, Curriculum Transaction, Basics of Communication in Adult Learning, Curriculum Transaction, Communication Media, Systems and Strategy. Then comes Curriculum Transaction, Role of Information and Communication Technologies. Then comes Curriculum Evaluation in Adult Education. Coming to the second course, that is MA002, titled Policy Planning and Implementation of Adult Education in India, the first block deals with 5-year plans and adult education. There it covers current adult education policy and programs, adult education administration, resource support structures of adult education, new initiatives and emerging challenges. Second block deals with implementing agencies. There it covers role of government departments, role of universities, colleges and students, role of non-governmental organizations, role of local bodies, community and individuals. The third block that deals with participatory training and research in adult education, it covers participatory training, concept and processes, then participatory training methodology and materials, learning environment of participatory training, participatory research. Then block 4 covers towards lifelong learning. And you know that now the concept we are giving emphasis for lifelong learning. So here in lifelong learning block, the major discussions are on post-literacy and continuing education, institutionalization of continuing education, reading materials for neoliterates and semi-literates, role of libraries in post-literacy and continuing education. Coming to the next course, that is MA003, Knowledge Management, Information, Dissemination and Networking in Adult Education. The first block deals with knowledge and documentation. There, the learners will cover the concept types and management of knowledge, the management of knowledge in an adult learning setup, documentation, how they can do, what is the concept of it, what are the services and how we can evaluate documentation. Then adult learning setup, role of process documentation. Block 2, which is titled Information Management and Dissemination, there you will learn about information dissemination, the basics of information dissemination, the services in information dissemination, standards for information management and dissemination, managing a library in an adult learning setup, building library resources and services. Next block, that is networking and adult learning. There it covers networking in social and professional life, understanding networking in adult learning. Next, computer networks, information networking, production and dissemination. Aladdin, case study of a network of networks. So Aladdin, it is dealing with the adult learning association of networks. Next block, that is dealing with block 4, Network Management for Learning Society Networking, which covers organizational behavior, dynamics of working together, expansion of Aladdin, India, marching towards learning society. Then comes MES016, Educational Research, where it covers block 1, Perspective of Knowledge. That the first unit, you will get familiarity with the basics of educational research, knowledge generation, the historical perspective, and then approaches to educational research. The second block titled Different Types of Studies in Educational Research. It covers descriptive research, experimental research, qualitative research, philosophical and historical studies. Then block 3, which is titled Research Design. There a learner will get familiarity with identification of problem and formulation of research questions, hypothesis, nature of formulation, sampling, tools and techniques of data collection. Block 4, which is titled Data Analysis and Interpretation, there it covers analysis of quantitative data, analysis of quantitative data where it covers the parametric test, and then the next one, the analysis of quantitative data, there the non-parametric test, then comes the analysis of qualitative data, then data analysis in qualitative research, data analysis techniques, what are used in qualitative research, computer data analysis. Coming to the fifth block, titled Research Reports and Applications, there a learner will get understanding about how to write a research proposal or synopsis, method of literature review, then research report, various components and structures, scheme of chapterization and referencing structure. Then comes the next course, MA004, Extension Education and Development. When you see the different course titles, now you may understand that how this program is cutting across the different curriculum, the different subjects. So here in this course, MA004, it is purely devoted to Extension Education and Development, where the first block deals with Introduction to Extension Education and Development, where it covers the concept, principles and philosophy in extension education, the development of extension education in India, extension methods and media, the development, what is the concept, dimensions and factors, current trends and policies in adult and extension education in India. The second block is purely devoted to dynamics of extension and development. There it covers evolution of extension models, dynamics of development, marginalization, the developmental disparities. Then comes the block, the third block, titled Problems and Issues in Development, where it covers basic issues in development, sectorial issues in development, social issues in development, issues and problems of governance in development. Next block, that is block 4, Extension and Development, Planning, Management and Evolution, there a learner can study it about planning and developing extension program, concepts and theories of management, manpower planning and personal management in extension and development, monitoring and evaluation. Course MA005, it deals with population and development education. The first block, population and development education and overview, which covers the concept and development of population education, demographic concepts, determinants of population change, consequences of population change, population and development education, relevant terms, misconceptions and clarifications. Block 2, titled Family Life Education and Quality of Life, which covers family life, adolescence education, sex education, family welfare, gender equality and equity. Third block, titled Population Control Measures, Individual, National and International, which covers individual measures, national measures, international measures. Next course, MA001, Sustainable Development. The block 1, it deals with Introduction to Sustainable Development, which covers sustainable development concept and scope, and approaches and strategies that is used in sustainable development, challenges to sustainable development. Next block, Rural Development, which deals with rural development in Indian context, then Rural Development Administration, Rural Development Programs. Third block, it deals with Tribal Development, Scheduled Areas and Tribes, Tribal Development Policy and Programs, Tribal Welfare Planning and Management. Next block, it is purely devoted to Urban Development, where it covers Introduction to Urban Development Issues and Challenges, Urban Development Policies and Programs, Urban Planning, Governance and Management. Next block, next course, that is MA061, Open and Distance Learning System. The first block, titled Open and Distance Learning Concepts and Developments, it covers ODL concepts and philosophy, historical development of ODL, organization and delivery. Next block 2, Instructional Inputs, where it covers self-learning materials, methods and media, design and preparation of materials, e-learning, concept and design. Block 3, title Instructional Transaction and Delivery, where it covers learning from self-learning materials, learning support services, resources and delivery, tutoring and counseling, delivery through e-learning, virtual environment. Block 4, title Evaluation and Research in ODL, where it covers assessment in ODL, program evaluation, research and development, and unit 4, recent trends in evaluation and research. Block 5, it is titled Recent Trends and Developments in ODL, National and International Perspective, where it covers paradigm shift in ODL, national and international agencies in distance education, globalization and the ODL system. And the next course, MAEA002, Basics of Legal Awareness, where the first block is devoted to essentials of Indian legal system, where it covers concept and basic principles of law, substantive law and procedural law, justice delivery system, implementation of law, empowering laws is the second block, where it covers the Constitution of India, Right to Information Act 2005, Protection of Women Against Domestic Violence Act 2005, which is a great debating act in the present COVID-19 pandemic crisis, where there occurs various type of domestic violence. Next comes the Right to Education, that is Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009, Right to Work, National and Employment Guarantee, National and Rural Employment Guarantee Act 2005. The next block, that is Liability Creating Laws, where it covers Indian Penal Code, Tort Law, Contract Law, Family Law. Then block 4 covers Legal Remedies Law, where it covers writs as remedies, law of specific performance, law of compensation, law of legal and law of human rights, panchayat rights law. Fifth block, title Special Rights Law, where it covers rights of children, rights of women, rights of workers, rights of Dalits and tribals, rights of landholders, rights of persons with disabilities, rights of parents and senior citizens. And next course, that is MAEC 062, Vocational Education. The first block is devoted to vocational education for sustainable national development, where it covers emergence of vocational education, policy dimensions and perspective, vocational education and national development support system. The second block, national scenario, where it covers context and coverage, issues and concerns of vocational education, curricular design and implementation strategies, innovations and case studies are also explained. Third block, titled Global Perspective, where it covers dual model, Germany, the vocational education system of China, then vocational education system of Australia. The next block, Recent Trends in Vocational Education, that it covers work-centered education as foundation of vocational education, the changing society and the consequence of vocational education and training. Next comes Vocational Education and Training Partnership Model. Next comes Entrepreneurship and Vocational Education. Fifth block, titled Futuristic Approach, that is Vocational Education for All, Traditional Vocational Education and Reforms in the Current Context, Vocational Education and Human Development, Lifelong Learning, Vocational Education and Training. Coming to the practical work, there we can see that for PGDAE and MAAE, the practical components, there are 10 credits. It consists of 3 community-based practical activities, 3 credits, workshop-based practical activities, 2 credits, then adult education training center or institution-based practical activities, 5 credits. For PGCAE, certificate program, only 1 practical component, that is community-based practical activities, which carries 3 credits. When coming to the practical work components, community-based practical activities, it consists of 2 compulsory activities of 2 credits, then optional activities which worth 1 credit. What is the objectives of this workshop-based practical activities? The first objective is to provide students an opportunity for face-to-face interaction with a peer group, academic counselors and other resource persons. Second one, to provide students with an opportunity to submit the reports of community-based practical activities which they have carried in their field, they can submit here. Then to facilitate students' attachment and linkages with the center, institution identified by him or her for internship, and orient and prepare him or her for other activities to be performed by as a part of their adult education training center. Next objective, to help student develop a research proposal, be it for conducting any individual based research or for a project to get a sanction of funds. Next one, to develop an understanding and skills of starting and running a voluntary organization or NGO with the mutual cooperation and support of his or her peers, community members and others as a step towards institutionalizing their vision and future activities for community development, welfare and networking for lifelong education and training of adults. Then little bit on this dissertation work, that is MAEP 001, which is compulsory in Master of Arts in Adult Education. There is it is compulsory for all students. There is a separate handbook on dissertation work. Weightage, dissertation report 80% and viva voice 20%. When we look at the submission details and everything, it should be submitted to the regional director, the proposal and the final report. And there we can see that the viva voice is compulsory for this dissertation work. So this is all about the courses of this adult education program. And when we can see that, when we look at the term adult education, there mostly some kind of doubts is coming, whether it is particularly limited to neoliterates. No, it's not like that. It is not for neoliterates. It is meant for those who are continuing education. During this pandemic crisis also, as adults, we are getting some knowledge about the online education, how to develop online tools and everything. This is also a part of adult education. So we can see that this adult education, it can be stated that which is not as part of formal schooling, all such type of programs and activities comes under adult education. So now the admission is open. Hope that you will be ready for taking admission for this adult education program, postgraduate certificate, postgraduate diploma and Master of Arts in Adult Education, which is only offering in July session. So I am concluding this session with the statement that never stop learning, ever stop learning. Thank you.